What's happening, everyone? My name is Alex and welcome back. So electricity prices are going up and up and up. It seems that every single month we get to pay more for electricity. So when EcoFlow reached out to me and asked me if I want to test out their new solar system, the EcoFlow Stream, of course I said yes, because I knew I would be saving some money on my electricity bill. So thanks EcoFlow for sending over the EcoFlow Stream so I can test it out. So what exactly is the EcoFlow Stream? Well, the EcoFlow Stream is a solar system that you install yourself. You basically have the solar panels, you connect the solar panels with the EcoFlow Stream Ultra. That's a battery pack that has a capacity of 1.92 kilowatt hour. You can get up to 6 of those batteries together on one system. So just under 12 kilowatt hour of capacity if you want to install more. But you can just do the whole system with only one. In my case, I have the EcoFlow Stream Ultra and the EcoFlow Stream AC Pro, I believe. I'll show you those in just a second. But I basically have 4 solar panels. The solar panels connect to that EcoFlow Stream Ultra, and that gets plugged into a wall socket at home. So now I'm getting all the power that the solar panels generate from the sun, and I'm putting that in my home's electrical grid. So this way I don't have to take as much power from the electrical grid. Now, there are some appliances that of course will use more power than the solar panels can generate. And in those situations, of course, you're also using power from the grid. But for most of the time during the day, my solar panels actually make enough electricity that I don't have to take any power from the grid. All right, so these are 2 of the solar panels that I use. I have them positioned here temporarily. I'm not exactly sure I'm gonna have them installed permanently. I have a couple of ideas, but for now they are right here. So these are 450 watt solar panels. Now, it really depends how much sun you get during the day, where you have them positioned and so on. My system makes about 10 kilowatt hours per day. So that's about half of the electricity that I use every single day. So I have these 2 panels right here. Then I have my 3rd panel right here. So this is the first one that gets sunlight in the morning. The other 2 that I showed you earlier get sunlight a bit later in the day. So this is basically the first one that gets sunlight. And then I have my 4th solar panel positioned right here. So kind of in the backyard, this one gets the most sun later on in the day and in the evening. Now, you can also get these mounting brackets, let's call them. There are a variety of them that you can order from EcoFlow's website. I believe these ones are the ones for a flat roof, designed for a flat roof. In my case, I use them on the ground. But you can choose different ones depending on your needs, because of course not everyone has the space to install solar panels like this. Now, the solar panels come, not the solar panels, the EcoFlow Stream Ultra does come with a few cables, but the cables are fairly short. So in my situation here, you can probably see the 2 cables just going that way. I had to get cables myself, and I actually made the connectors for these cables myself. And I'll show you where I have all the solar panels connected. Okay, so the cables from the other panel that I showed you go around there. Then we have the cables from these 2 panels that go around here. All the cables kind of go together. All right, so the cables from the 4 solar panels end up here. This is the EcoFlow Stream Ultra. This can support up to 2000 watts of solar input. And as you can see here, you can connect 4 panels to the back of this. And of course, this gets plugged into a wall socket, and that's how the system kind of works. You basically get all that power from the sun that goes into the battery pack here, and the battery pack puts it into your home's grid. At the top here, we also have 2 AC plugs. So in my case here, for example, I have that pool cleaner connected to the EcoFlow Stream Ultra, and I basically charge that whenever it needs charging right from this AC plug right here. Now, you can connect more of these batteries in parallel. There is a cable that you can get from EcoFlow, and you can have 2 of these battery packs connected in parallel. And then the maximum AC output is up to 2300 watts. So if you have other things at home, like a hairdryer or something like that, you could use those right from your EcoFlow Stream Ultra. It really depends on the situation. Now, you do get these cables with your EcoFlow Stream Ultra. I believe that's where I got these cables. There are about 8 cables or 4 cables. I honestly don't remember. But in my case, because I have the panel so far away from the EcoFlow Stream Ultra, I actually had to buy my own cable and the connectors and make my own cables. Now, if you don't know how to do that, you're probably better off to buy cables that are already made. But overall, it's easy to make your own system sort of situation, if you know what I mean. Another thing that's worth mentioning is the fact that the EcoFlow Stream Ultra here is also weather resistant. So you could keep this outside. Now, ideally, you don't keep this in direct sunlight because it will get too hot. It can cool itself down, but it's best that you don't keep it in direct sun. And the way I have it positioned here, it never gets too hot. It's always in the shade. But yes, these are weather resistant as well. And next, I want to show you where I have the other battery pack connected. I actually keep that connected inside the house into another wall socket. But basically, as the system gets energy from the sun, it will charge this battery here, of course, and then it will charge the other one, the AC Pro. And as the sun goes away in the evening, it's using the power from these battery packs to power the house. All right, and now we are in the house. This is where I have the EcoFlow Stream AC Pro connected. So it's connected to a wall socket behind that plant there. And as you can see, it's actually charging right now with power that the solar panels are generating. So these two batteries will get full as the day goes by. Now, it really depends how much power I'm also using throughout the day, because some days when I have the ACs running and so on, there isn't enough power generated to actually fill up the batteries as well. This one also has two AC plugs right there, but I don't actually use this one as much. I use the one that's outside, so the Ultra, more than this one. The positioning of this one doesn't really allow me to connect anything to it. But if there would be like a power outage or something, I could move this anywhere in the house and plug in anything in these two AC plugs that we have right here. Now, in order to get an even more efficient system, it is recommended that you also install a smart meter like this one. Now, if you don't know how to do this, I highly recommend that you get an electrician to do it. You don't want to be touching the electrical panel if you don't know what you're doing. So probably best to get an electrician to get this installed. But basically, when you get this installed, you will be able to track all the power that goes through your house. So whatever power it's being used, whatever the power is needed, you will be able to track everything much better with this. There are also these smart plugs that you can get. I actually have one installed for the fridge and one for the water heater. So you can power these on and off remotely. You can set timers with them. And very importantly, you can track the consumption of anything in the house. So if you're curious to see how much your fridge is using, well, you can find all that with these smart plugs right here. So in my case, I have the smart meter installed right here. Now, as I said, if you don't know how to do this, it is best to get an electrician to do this because you're gonna have to open the electrical panel. And if you don't know what you're doing, definitely get some professional help. But basically with this installed, I can keep track of all the electricity that comes from the grid. I know exactly how much power everything is using in the house. So you do get a much better idea of when the house is using power, what the power is being used for, and so on. And you basically keep track of everything with the EcoFlow app. And next I'm gonna be showing you that EcoFlow app, I guess. All right, so I had to come inside the house so I can show you the app. I also found that parallel cable. So this is the cable that you'd use if you wanna connect the
Stream Ultra or the Stream AC Pro. And if you do use both power stations connected in parallel, then they can output up to 2300 watts. So you can power a lot of devices at home with that power. So let me start recording the screen here. So this is the EcoFlow app. I'm gonna have this on the screen so you can see. So when you first open the app here, you can see how much power the solar panels are actually generating right now. It is 11:15, so it's not peak power quite yet. The peak power I've seen around 1.4, sometimes 1.45 kilowatts. So currently the solar panels are generating 770 watts and the house is using about 220 watts right now. Now on the screen here, you can also see that smart meter. And if you click on it, you can see how much power you're currently using from the grid. So 8 watts, 2 watts from the grid. And if you click on the lifetime consumption, you can actually see for every single day how much power you actually used. So this is August 6. If we go to August 5, you can see that I imported 17 kilowatt hours from the grid. On August 4th, I only used 10.81 kilowatt hours from the grid. So you get the idea. This is basically that smart meter that I showed you earlier. Now, on the main page here, you also have the two batteries. So first of all, the Stream Ultra right here. So if you click on that, you can see exactly what's happening with that. So the solar panels are generating power and you can see exactly how much each solar panel is generating. And you can see what's happening with all that power generated by the solar panels. So I'm basically bringing 770 watts in and the system it's outputting to the house's grid 616 watts or 614, depending on the time of the day and what's using power, of course. And if we go into the AC Pro, you can see that it's actually charging from those solar panels. So it's taking the surplus energy that we get from the solar panels and it's charging this battery. Once this one is full, the Ultra will also get charged as well. So as you can see now, the home it's using 230 watts, right? If I power on the AC, you'll see immediately what happens. So it's gonna take a second till it starts. But you'll see that the home, it's using power from the grid as well now. Because of course, this is using quite a bit of power. So we're pulling about 80 watts from the grid. The whole home, it's still using 440 watts. But you've seen that it's much more than the house was using previously. Now, if we go to the left here, you can actually see how much power the solar panels generated every single day. Now, it's early in the day today on August 6th, but we'll go to yesterday. So yesterday, the solar panels generated 9.99 kilowatt hours. And here you can actually see the graph, how that power was generated by each solar panel. So if we go here, we can see that around 3:30, 3:15, I was generating 1.35 kilowatts. So the peak, I think it was about here, 1.4. And you can basically see this every single day. So August 4th, I made 9.91 kilowatt hours. The previous day on August 3rd, I made 10.45. So this is basically cutting about half of my electricity usage because every day I use about 20 to 25, but I make about 10 from those solar panels and through the EcoFlow Stream Ultra. So my electricity bill should be cut in half at the end of the month. And you can get a lot of these stats here everywhere. So there is a lot of information in everything here. You can also select the discharge limit for those battery packs that you have. So if you want the Ultra, for example, to just stay at 80%, you never want to charge it to 100%, you have that possibility here, so you can change everything about the system basically. For the smart meter monitoring, you don't necessarily need that smart meter, but if you do get the smart meter, I feel that the system does run more efficiently because it knows better what's using power and when it's using power, so it can output more power from those battery packs. Now, depending on your location, this system can output somewhere between 600 to 1200 watts to your house. But each country has a different limit. But whenever you select the country where you're located, the app and the system knows exactly the limit for that particular country. To give you an example, I believe Italy has like a 600 watt limit, Spain has like a 800 watt limit, I believe the UK has an 800 watt limit, but there are other places that allow up to 1200 watts. But the app knows that based on your location anyway, so you don't really have to do much. So that's how the EcoFlow system is integrated into your home. You basically bring all that power from the sun, and then the system uses that power from the sun in your house. So anything that uses power in your house comes directly from the sun through that wall socket that you have the Ultra connected to your house, if that makes some sense. So that's how the app basically works. In this case right here, you can see that one of the batteries is discharging at about 182 watts. The whole house is using about 797 watts, and we are generating about 550 watts from the sun. So right now I'm basically running that AC for free because I've got all that power from the sun, which is pretty cool to see. And you see that a lot throughout the day. Now, if you do have like five AC units going at the same time, this is not gonna be the case, but you understand what I'm saying. So a very, very cool system. So just a quick look so you can see how the app looks and what the app shows you throughout the day.
So for now, it's only been about 5 days with the solar panels installed. I've had that smart meter installed before the solar panels and all that. So I do need a bit more time so I can get a better understanding what the system does. I would also love to see some electricity bills so I can actually compare the how much power I used versus what the smart meter measures. But I will need to see an electricity bill for that. Now, I'm not sure I'm gonna install the panels permanently. I was thinking of getting 4 more panels and maybe another Ultra, just so I can generate more power throughout the day, and then I can use more power at night. Because realistically, at night, when you have 2 AC units going, you do go through those 1.92 kilowatt hours battery packs quite fast. So I may get another Ultra, maybe another AC Pro. I am still thinking about it, but I definitely want more solar panels because I would love to make more electricity during the day because we have so much sun here that it would make sense to generate more and use it at night. So basically what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna keep track of what the system does. I also wanna put these cables better, like some cable management, because as you can see for now, the whole system is kind of set up temporarily, let's say. So I'm gonna keep track and see what the system does over the next couple of weeks. And then I'll make another video talking about my experience after a while when I get a better understanding about the system, see the performance over a longer period of time, see how those solar panels generate power when it's cloudy out, for example. But basically the EcoFlow Stream solar system is extremely easy to use. You just put the solar panels out, you just plug that into a wall socket, and you don't really have to do much. Of course, you have to add those devices to the EcoFlow app, but everything is very easy and you can do it however you want. You don't actually need like an electrician to come and install all that, and you could use the whole system without that smart meter as well. I mean, when you don't have the smart meter, the EcoFlow Stream Ultra still kind of tracks what usage your house has, so you can use the system without that smart meter, but I feel that the smart meter does make the system a bit more efficient. And these are my other solar panels. So if you guys have any questions, leave some questions down below and I'll try answering whatever questions you may have into the future video that I will be making about the EcoFlow Stream. Once again, thanks EcoFlow for sending this over, and I will talk to you guys in the next video.